It's time once again for that business show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ, where business becomes show business. Jamie is a leading Tampa Bay real estate agent and featured on the Wall Street Journal's list of top 100 real estate agents in the nation. Jamie invites you to list your home with him today and learn more at tampabayradio.com. Now, live in studio and promoting the entrepreneurial spirit that drives the American economy, your host, Jamie Maloney.
Hey, good morning, everybody, and happy Thursday, and welcome to yet another episode of That Business Show, Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. We're on Monday through Friday, 7 to 9, here live on Tampa Bay's 1250 Winds WHNZ, and also live video stream available over at tampabayradio.com. In studio, as always, Josh Vosda running the live video stream and chiming in from time to time with a little color commentary and also our celebrity look-alike. So, Ava Veet, you'll be getting a celebrity look-alike up here on the screen here in just a little bit. Unbeknownst to her, she's like, okay, I didn't even know that. So Josh holds it down over there, and that is our first guest for the
She made me promise I wouldn't make fun of her on air.
Which is Ava Veet Ben-Aaron, founder and clinical director of Great 8 Speech, and she is a speech therapist, and this is an online portal where she communicates with her clients, and people, I guess, can use this to communicate and track progress about speech therapy with their loved ones, friends, family. And the website for this is great8speech.com. That's G-R, the number 8, speech.com. So, Ava Veet, welcome to the program today.
Hi, good morning. Thank you so much for having me.
So, let's just begin a little bit more a background on what Great 8 Speech is.
So it's actually spelled together, Great Speech. That's the name of the company. And what we do is we provide speech therapy services online. So it's an innovative and highly effective way of communicating with our clients and delivering speech therapy services.
Okay, so how did this platform come together? You're a speech therapist by trade, and I assume that this came into your career at some point after you became a therapist. How did this come together?
Exactly. So I was a speech-language pathologist, and I worked in a very traditional clinical setting. And I remember coming out about 6 or 7 years ago into a waiting room and watching a mom who's struggling to... Her son was receiving therapy with us, and she had to bring all three of her kids with her. So as this child was getting therapy, the other three kids had to be managed. So one she was feeding dinner to, and one she was trying to do homework with, and one she was trying to occupy at the same time. And when I walked out, she looked visibly anxious and upset about this whole setup. And she actually looked at me and said, "Why can't we do this on the computer? It would be so much easier for me if you just made it on the computer." And I went home and I spoke with my husband and I said, "Well, why can't we do it on the computer?" And
do you find that your clients are more comfortable on the online platform versus an office setting?
Absolutely. Clients are so much more comfortable. The clients that we're seeing tend to be very busy. So families are very busy today. Time is of the essence. We don't want to spend the time driving and commuting. And also, I think people are much more comfortable in the comfort of their own home or office.
Now, do you work primarily like with children in your practice? Do you work with the teens, all levels of people?
So we really work with all levels. Okay. Our youngest client is about 5, and our oldest is about 75 now. We work with kids who have lisps and stutter and have language disorders or speech disorders. And then we work with adults who may or may not have issues with their accent or stuttered as a child and now want to resolve these issues again as an adult, or people who've been through stroke or traumatic brain injury or any kind of cognitive issues. And we really support those clients whatever stage they are in their therapy.
Now, you use this platform to communicate with your own clients. Is this platform available for public use?
So the platform that we use is really a web conferencing platform. Okay. And the idea is that the client and the therapist engage one-on-one within a therapeutic context. So what we're doing is we provide the therapy, we follow goals, we maintain the effectiveness of the therapy, but just the medium that we're using is different or more innovative than the traditional.
And are you at a point now where you see the majority of your clients through the GR8 or Great? I'm going to say Great 8 Speech.
I know.
Her logo says GR8 Speech.
Right. Better, but Great Speech, than me, dude. I kept saying Grape Ape.
I know, but it's right. Great Speech. But I want to say Great 8 Speech. Right. But are you using that primarily to see all your clients?
Yes, that's the primary model of our therapy. Most of our clients, again, are very busy, and this allows us to maintain very effective speech therapy services. So if somebody's traveling over the summer, we maintain the therapy services just as well.
Can you tell me about the difference that you've seen in the clients that you treat through the portal versus the clients that you treat in an office setting,
yes,
for instance?
So first of all, we're getting a lot more inquiries now and a lot more interest with clients that are teenagers and young adults. because this is an age where typically teenagers don't want to address their communication issues and feel as if they everything is great, but there are some issues that need to be addressed, and they don't want to go to a traditional therapy center where they may be feeling like there is a stigma or they just doesn't work into their schedule. So we enable them to receive the therapy in a very, very consistent and effective way.
For parents that are listening and they have children that they think may be having some speech therapy issues, I know I have them sometimes on this radio show with my tongue tied in this, but nonetheless, at what age should a parent begin to get concerned about their children's speech and seek out assistance?
Absolutely. So around the age of about 2 years old, we want to make sure that the child is able to put some words together, is showing good eye contact, some understanding of simple directions. These are the kind of milestones that we're looking for. So if a child at two and a half is not reaching those milestones, this would be definitely a red light to bring up to the pediatrician and to discuss with the pediatrician and then see if there's a need for.
What disorders are children suffering from that cause these speech impediments? Is it just lisps? Is there some type of brain wiring that's not proper?
So no, there could be a lisp. It could be just a child is slow to develop language skills, is slow to develop new words or acquire new words or putting words together. Some kids could potentially have more of a autistic-like characteristics that we want to really reach out to early on. And because early intervention really makes a huge difference in the results that we're receiving in terms of therapy.
And you say that parents should bring their children in around between the ages of 2 or 3, but at what time do parents typically react to this type of situation?
So usually it might be a little bit older than that, unless the pediatrician and the parents are communicating regularly and the pediatrician picks out on these kind of milestones and notices that this child is not reaching the milestones.
And what kind of damages are done by waiting longer and longer to seek assistance?
Depending on what the initial issue is, it could really be very detrimental. So it's essential that kids receive the early intervention as early as possible, and as early as 18 months if other milestones haven't been met. We want to see the children.
Now, how did you find the field of speech therapy? Has this always been a love of yours?
So it's very interesting. Actually, when I was 14, my family and I relocated from Israel to New York. And I really did not speak any English. And I distinctly remember sitting in the classroom, not being able to communicate with my peers, and being made fun of, feeling very isolated. And I think in the back of my head, that was always something that left a mark. And as I got older, I was looking for a profession where I can help other people communicate and become more effective.
Do you deal a lot with people that are learning English as a language?
Yes, yes,
and is
absolutely.
That a concern of many people, or I should say a problem with many people?
There's definitely concern. We're getting, again, a lot of our clients that we're a lot of the inquiries they're receiving are people who are actually in their 20s, and now that they're ready to go into the workforce, feel like their accents or their dialect is getting in the way of their ability to express themselves.
So you then probably understand how accents really come about and why once somebody's voice forms, it can't be changed, why their accent really can't go. What's going on with the internally with an accent that it can't be modified?
So accent has to do with just whatever language, however you acquired the initial language, but it does impact the ability of people to communicate, and people tend to judge people with accents just naturally.
But if you learn a language in one country and you come to another, it's very difficult enunciate some of those words. But
absolutely.
What physically is going on inside the body
so
with
I
the voice
box?
So
I think part of it is just in terms of, it's not so much physically, it's just in terms of the age in which you arrive. So the younger you are, the easier it is to remediate an accent. The older you are, the harder it is to change the pattern. It's a pattern of speech. So if you need to change it, it just takes that much longer. Just like if you were walking in a certain way and now you have to walk in a different way, it's going to take you that much longer.
Is there a certain language that does not mix very well with English in terms of you see a lot of these types of clients, maybe Asian speaking people versus Middle Eastern?
I would not generalize. It really depends a lot on your own personal motivation to remediate. People could be in their 50s and 60s and make a change in their speech pattern and their accent, and they could be, you know, younger.
But coming from one language to English is what I'm saying. Is there any one particular language that's particularly difficult?
I think when you're trying to learn English is not an easy language, both in terms of grammar and in terms of speech and articulation. So I just think overall, it's just a matter of how motivated are you to make the change.
Yes, and I've heard that a number of times that English is one of the hardest languages to learn. And you said you yourself had to learn it.
Yes, second language. And every time I learned a rule in grammar, I was told, oh, wait, but there is an exception to that rule. So just hold on to that.
There's so many different rules. rules, plus just tone plays such a big play, and sarcasm, and it changes.
Absolutely.
Words that sound the same that mean different things.
Oh, yes. It took me a very long time to learn that, and then spelling it. There's just a whole slew of issues when you're learning a second language.
How did you learn English? Did you go through a traditional teacher? Did you learn it by, I know some of my friends learned it from watching TV.
Where I went to a public school, and in the public school that I was in, they had an English as a second language program, which was great. And it was an intense English remediation program. And basically the idea was that all my academic instruction took place in that program. But I really felt very isolated because none of the kids spoke my language. Everybody spoke different languages. It was almost like the UN. We all kind of were speaking different languages, and nobody really was able to communicate. And it really left such a mark that I really wanted to make sure that if a child moves into, you know, moves to a new place, or families move, that they have the support that they need and not have to go through this.
How long does speech therapy take? Does it differ from person to person, or is there, you usually see results within months to, you know, a few weeks, or how does that work?
That's a great question. It's very hard to tell. It has to do a lot with how motivated the client is to improve. So when we have clients that are highly motivated and are willing to put in the work and really make the effort, it makes a huge difference. But it really varies from person to person, and depending on the issue and the ailment and how old they are in time of remediation also.
For people that are listening right now that may be suffering from a speech impediment, or maybe their children need assistance, what's the best way to get in touch with you? What's a good first step? Do you offer a free consultation?
Absolutely.
How does this? Tell
Absolutely
us a little about
we
this.
We do. We offer a free consultation. So the first step would be to visit our website, which is greatspeech.com, and gr8speech.com. And request a free consultation, and we will reach out to the client and set up an initial consultation, which is complimentary. And the purpose of that consultation is to make sure that this client would be a good client for our services.
And how does insurance tie into this?
Insurance right now is not covering the services. What we do is we offer the necessary documentation so for the person to submit to their insurance company. But right now, insurance is not covering our services.
No employer plans. Some employer plans cover some type of speech therapy.
But they typically cover more of the traditional setting, not so much the online model.
Okay, I see the difference.
The innovative online model the insurance companies haven't caught.
So you're really just taking the platform to the internet instead of in our office, and it makes a difference with the insurance companies?
Yes.
Wow, incredible how just that one change makes that difference.
For the insurance companies, yes.
Currently talking to Avavit Ben-Aron. She is a founder and clinical director of Grout. You can learn more about this at gr8speech.com or send an email out to them for more information at info@grout.com. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their shop-at-home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made well-born cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at JaegerFlooring.com.
I knew Mom wanted to stay at home. It's the center of her family, her life. But helping Mom stay in her home while managing mine was just too much. Honestly, it wasn't just about me. Mom didn't want me to be her caretaker. She wanted me to be her daughter. I felt so alone until I found out about Home Instead Senior Care. When we met the people at Home Instead, we just knew they were different. The experience was personal. And most importantly, for Mom and me, I get to be her daughter again.
Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
Savvy business owners utilize technology to connect with customers, communicate among teams, and collaborate with partners. Even with advances in technology, you all know it's not infallible. Where do you turn when your technology starts working against you? Who do you depend on to keep your team productive? Don't wait until your technology fails you. Get ahead of the crisis and contact the professionals at Alpha Computing Solutions so they can show you how to keep your technology running smoothly. Visit them online at www.alphacomputing.com.
How many times have you said to yourself, I wish there was an app for that? Stop wishing and start making the world better. Turn your brilliant idea into a profitable business by using Popcorn Apps. Their affordable app design will help get your blue sky idea or proven business to the next level at a fraction of the cost of other developers. They will help you get through all the steps needed to make your thoughts become live. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn, or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a million-dollar business and a world changer starting today.
At Vane 911, we will help you feel great again. Do you have restless legs, night leg cramps, or ankle swelling? Restless legs, cramping, swelling, and tired heavy legs are often symptoms of hidden vein disease. You do not have to have visible bulging veins to have the symptoms of vein disease. The vein care specialists at Vein 911 are uniquely qualified to evaluate and treat your veins. Are you unhappy with your previous vein treatment? Vein 911 succeeds where others fail. Call Vein 911 today at 855-VEIN-911. That's 855-834-6911 to book your free consultation. Vein 911. We will help you feel great again.
Who doesn't have a smartphone these days? And of course, there's an app for everything. Well, almost everything. That's why the folks at Popcorn Apps started developing mobile applications. They saw people like you with genius ideas unable to make those thoughts a reality. They develop applications for tens of thousands of dollars less than you'll find anywhere else and will turn your idea into a reality in a matter of just a few months. Think you're not ready? Think again. They are your one-stop shop for mobile application development. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn. Or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a million-dollar business and a world changer starting today.
From the Bright House Networks Traffic Center.
Heavy traffic on eastbound State Road 52 approaching Old Pasco Road and I-75. Of course, construction causing those delays through there. Also, southbound I-75 jam between Fletcher Avenue and I-4. Northbound I-75 approaching I-4, crash off to the right-hand side and the southbound side of the Veterans Expressway, now very slow between Hutchinson to past water. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abrahamson New York. Hillsborough Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation. Someone you know is suffering from Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. They're dealing with excruciating pain and days when they won't be able to get out of bed. Help someone you know and support the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation of America at ccfa.org.
Today, sunny, then a 40% chance of showers and thunderstorms, high 92. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 77. Tomorrow, a 40% rain chance with a high 91.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 WINS WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Talking to Avavit Ben-Aron. She is the founder and clinical director of Great Speech. And learn more about this at the website greatspeech.com. And that's GR8speech.com. So Avavit, share with us some of the success stories of some of the people that you've worked with through the years.
So I've been so blessed, and we've really seen such a wide variety of clients. And one of the things that I noticed, because we can provide this therapy online, is really more than just the clients making success, is the fact that families are having an easier time integrating into the therapy. So we have clients where the daughter of a man who had a stroke can now log into the therapy, even though she lives in Wyoming and her father lives in New York. So she can be part of the therapy, and I think that's something really incredible that we can offer to our clients, that typically in a traditional setting, there is no way she could have attended that session. So now she can log in remotely. Or the mom, we oftentimes have parents who set up the therapy schedule around their work schedules, and therefore, again, they can log in remotely and still be part of the therapy and observe the therapy and have their input in the therapy, which I think is incredible.
Now, I'm sure you've come across people that you cannot treat for various reasons, but generally speaking, what is an average success rate of people that come through your office?
So what we do in that initial complementary screening, the purpose of that complementary screening is to ensure that this type of therapy model would be successful with the clients that we're looking for. So if I suspect at that point that the client is not going to be a client that would benefit from this model of therapy, then we would make other recommendations.
Now, you mentioned in going into that last break that your model differs from the traditional models, but is the only difference that you're using the online portal? I mean, are there some other techniques that are different?
So, first of all of our therapists are trained to be to deliver this type of therapy. What I think is very, very unique in our model is because I don't have to add to our team or hire therapists based on geographical limitations. I can hire therapists anywhere in the country, as long as they have a skill set that is adding value to our members. So I have therapists who specialize in stuttering, and therapists who specialize in working with kids, and those who work with people who've had stroke or had a traumatic brain injury or car accident or things along those lines. So the team of therapists that we have is really of all really have unique skill set and sub skill sets.
You mentioned stuttering, and is stuttering as much of a speech issue, or is it more of an anxiety issue? I've wondered.
It's considered a communication disorder.
It is a speech issue. Okay.
Considered a communication disorder. Obviously, it's brought on a lot more time.
I have a question about that. Why, when I'm faced with a beautiful blonde, I start stuttering?
I don't know if I can help you with that. That's not within the realm of speech therapy.
That's where the anxiety part comes in.
Exactly. Right. So we all have a tendency to get a little, when we're nervous, to get a little bit more, have difficulty getting the words out. But that's different than somebody who has a habitual...
So it has nothing to do with anxiety. It's a true speech.
I wouldn't say that it has nothing to do with anxiety, but that's not the main reason. And that's why it does fall under the communication disorder umbrella. And that's why we as speech therapists are clinically trained to treat and really improve the
And
outcome.
How many different speech disorders are there? You mentioned lisp,
there are plenty. There's stuttering. There is articulation. There is... There's a very, very large slew of therapy.
And disorders. Are all the different disorders, are they all treatable just through basic voice techniques? Does anything ever require any type of surgical procedures?
So they are, absolutely, which is where we would not be able to necessarily support. So there are people who've had to have voice therapy done.
Actual surgical techniques?
Surgically on their vocal cords. Right, I couldn't get the words out. But yes, exactly that.
But that's rare, though?
It's not rare. Yeah, people who have nodules who speak incorrectly that really impact the ability for their vocal cords to work, to function properly.
But the large majority of the different disorders that you treat on a daily basis, you can work through, which is normal voice techniques.
Absolutely. We can work just the way in our model.
And so what have you grown your team into now? Tell me, you mentioned that you have therapists across the country with this portal. I mean, you can have an international model with this. Tell me a little bit more about the team that you have.
So I'm so proud because each one of our therapists that's added to our team is chosen because of their specific sub-skill sets and their personality and their ability to be innovative and creative and are really handpicked because of those skills. And that's what makes our team really a fabulous team. And that's why I think we're seeing the results that we're seeing with our clients.
What's the biggest progress or biggest success story that you've ever seen in your practice? Any child that you've taken from just a
not speaking
perfectly clear? Tell me about this.
We have a case where a child who was really nonverbal at all, and we worked with him and for the very first time, he said, I love you, to his mom. And that was a very, very heart-wrenching but beautiful moment. And then we have the clients who just feel their own success, that they feel like, wow, now I can go on a job interview because I can deliver my message in a very effective way. And I think that's incredible. Or a kid who was bullied because of his inability to produce a specific sound or sounded funny and now feels very confident when he goes back to school and knows, oh, wait a minute, I can actually say it the right way.
Good, very inspiring story. Josh, what do you got for me over there?
Oh, well, we have our celebrity lookalike.
And it is?
It's going to be Sansa Stark from Game of Thrones.
Ooh, hey, okay.
Nice, I can see that. So there you go. Look. Have you ever been compared to her before?
No, but I'll take it.
There you go. Now you have been. So just an added benefit of being on the program this morning. So
thank you.
Avavit Ben-Aaron, thank you so much for being in studio today.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Good information. And if you're in need of assistance for speech therapy, she uses, again, this online portal so she can assist you anywhere in the world. So learn more at the website greatspeech.com, and that's gr8speech.com, or send them a message through their email info@greatspeech.com. Again, gr8speech.com. Coming back from the break, we'll be talking with Greg Lynch. He is an owner and operator with Sir Grout. So if you got the dirty grout in the floors, which we all do, he can definitely help you out with that. So stay tuned for that interview. You're listening to That Business Show, Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
I feel guilty that I can't always be there when Mom feels stuck at home. She was always there for us. But now she can't get out, and I'm not always available to take her places. Someone else needs to help her get around. Then I learned about Home Instead. Now Mom can do what she enjoys because her personal caregiver is there, and I can just be a daughter again.
Are you struggling to care for your loved one? We can help. Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
Hi, welcome to Yeager's. We just want to take a minute and show you what we're all about. At Yeager's, our primary business is hardwood flooring, although we are remodelers for kitchen, bath, and general construction. We operate a fleet of shop-at-home vans that have all the flooring-type products, hardwood flooring, laminate flooring, tiles, stone, what have you. So we're able to come out first with products in our vehicles and take a look at the setting, how the colors will work, and then to be able to come up with some options and ideas for you. If that's not good enough, we have a large distribution center that we inventory product and have a nice display area.
Connector to around Waters Avenue and also westbound I-4 now from 75 over towards MLK. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abrahamson and Uterick. Hillsboro traffic tip line 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by the Hillsborough County Public Works. Help us to fight mosquitoes. Any outdoor debris that can hold water, like old tires and discarded appliances, can provide places for mosquitoes to breed. Find disposal options at hcflgov.net/solid waste or call 813-272-5680.
1250 Winds Weather Center forecast. High today in the low 90s. We'll see sunshine to start the day, with clouds picking up into the afternoon, rain chance kicking in then as well for 40% chance of scattered showers and storms, mid to upper 70s for the low, 30% chance of rain tomorrow, low 90s. Impact Radio, 1250 Winds, WHNZ.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds, WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Monday through Friday, 7 to 9 here on Tampa Bay's 1250 Winds, WHNZ. Video stream available over on TampaBayRadio.com. Time to bring in my next guest for the program. I have Greg Lynch, owner and operator of Sir Grout here in the Tampa Bay region. Learn more about this over at SirGroutTampa.com. Greg, welcome to the program today.
Thank you. Thank you very much for having me.
So first off, just tell me a little bit about your background. This is obviously, you know, Grout. You know, everybody knows what Grout is, or at least people know that what that is. But do you come from a contractor background, building and trade and construction? Tell me a little about your background first.
Actually, I don't. I'm from the Boston area originally. Okay. I started out in the insurance business. We worked with school teachers giving insurance presentations on group disability and group life products. I was transferred to Tampa probably 20 years ago or so. And after 3 or 4 years, our company was purchased by a company out of Indianapolis. And I continued to work with them for about a year or so. And from that point, they started to kind of mess with my compensation a little bit. So I decided to kind of go off on my own. So that's where I kind of began becoming an entrepreneur. Now, from that point on, things changed, you know, and I decided to change careers. And I decided that looking at the Tampa market, I looked at a couple of different businesses, and there's a lot of tile and grout in Tampa. So I decided to look into a couple of companies, and I found an ad for Sir Grout in one of the magazines, contacted them, met with one of the owners up in Connecticut, and one thing led to another, and I was the first owner of a Sir Grout franchise in the state of Florida.
What attracted you to then the Sir Grout model and to the grout business in general? Because that's got to be a tough business. I mean, just cleaning grout, getting down there on the hands and knees at times. I mean, tell me about what attracted you to that business.
You know, it is. It's a lot of work. We do have a proprietary system as well as proprietary, products. The biggest thing that differentiates us versus our competitors is the fact that there is a 4 or 5 step process. So we pretty much go from spraying the floor with a neutral cleaner, machine scrubbing, applying our sealant, and then we polish the floors at the end so that when we finish, it goes from, you know, dirty and dingy to looking brand new.
When did you open the business? And was this some 20 years ago, you said?
No, the Surgrout business I opened 7 years ago.
Okay. All right. So tell me about the process itself there. You mentioned that you differentiate yourself from other grout companies out there. And you also said that a lot of grout companies out there are not really truly grout companies. There are a lot of carpet companies out there that are offering the grout as a service. Tell about how you differentiate from that, too.
Well, what's happened in the industry these days is, you know, there's a lot of carpet companies out there. And a lot of people are finding out that they're tired of carpets. So what they do is they take their carpets up and they'll put down tile or grout or whatever. So in order to for the carpet companies to stay in business, they buy a separate attachment for which they'll come in and they'll put a steam machine across all of the carpets, and it gets hot water and steam, and the suction can be very strong. They're not going through all the steps that we do as far as, you know, step one to step four and finishing up. So it's night and day. I think there's a need for the carpet cleaning companies for maybe some of the commercial applications. But our process, we feel as though, since grout is so porous, if you're just going to clean it and not seal it, I think you're kind of wasting your time.
Now, is there one technique for all the different types of grout that's out there, or do you have to use different techniques for maybe different floor types, for instance?
You know, we stick with tile and grout for the most part, and, you know, occasionally we'll use, I've got a separate steamer that we use. It has an attachment that shoots steam up to about 220 degrees or so. But for the most part, in certain areas, we'll do kind of a pre-scrub. Usually kitchen areas, laundry rooms. Most people, when they come home, they usually come in. If they have a garage, they'll park in, come in through the garage, and usually the laundry room is right there, and that's usually where the traffic pattern is. And then as they go into the kitchen area, you always have your traffic patterns, and people get really frustrated how they can't get the grout back to looking brand new.
Now, you're hitting this with high-pressure steam slash water, correct? That's one of the steps?
I occasionally use our steamer.
Okay.
Now, our steamer is different than the ones that the carpet cleaners have in the sunset.
Okay, so that's what the carpet cleaners are doing.
Correct.
They're kind of just kind of pressure washing then the grout, for lack of a better term.
Yeah, we try to avoid heavy-duty pressure.
Yeah, doesn't that cause damage to the grout?
Yeah, if you use high-pressure steam, then yes, it can cause damage to the grout.
I was going to say, how are you not blasting the grout out from between the tiles when you're doing that?
We occasionally run into that. You know, for the most part, the carpet cleaning companies try to lower the tension on the machines, but every so often I run into some where the grout has come up.
But so your technique then uses a solvent of some sort then that goes in there and dissolves the dirt, and then you kind of wipe that up, and then you come back with a sealant. Is that kind of correct?
Correct. The process is we spray the tile and grout with a pH neutral cleaner. That's the first step. The second step is we'll do like a little pre-scrub in the high traffic areas. And then the third step is we have a commercial floor cleaner that has two brushes that are going to clean the floor and extract the dirty water. And then we get down with our toothbrushes and apply our sealants, and then we polish the floors.
What's the finish actually look like on the grout when you apply the sealer and it dries and takes hold? I've seen some where it almost looks like it's a thin layer of plastic and it's kind of shiny. Is that what you're talking about?
That's actually a great question. There's a couple of types of sealants in the industry, and most people are conditioned to having a clear seal. Part of the reason why I avoid clear seals is the fact that it gives it kind of a shiny look. And oftentimes it doesn't last near as long as our color sealer does.
Now, do you also, I guess, part of the process is you're also going to be, you know, getting solvents on the tiles and stuff too. The tiles themselves also get cleaned during the grout cleaning process too?
That's correct. And as far as solvents, they do. We don't use any strong, you know, cleaners for the most part. We're using a pH neutral cleaner. Every so often on a commercial application, we may go with a higher alkaline cleaner.
Rick's like, oh, he shot up real fast, grabbed his camera because I made this guy laugh. And Rick's like, oh, I missed the bus. And he looked at me all crazy real quick.
So what's the sealant is applied to the grout? How long does it last? How often do people, do you recommend people get the grout resurfaced and after that?
Great question. Generally, once we apply a sealant to the grout, it takes about probably 15 minutes to dry or so. Then, of course, we polish it. As far as the length of time that's going to last, a lot's going to depend on what exactly you're using as far as your cleaning methods. We try to get people to, you know, use a neutral cleaner and a mop. But generally, it should last anywhere between 5 to 7 years. Again, a lot's going to be dependent upon what types of products that they're using to clean it.
Now, you're obviously, it's tough to keep grout clean because you're mopping, you're pushing dirty water into crevices and it gets into the little pores and all that stuff. So, I mean, it's really difficult to keep, you know, grout clean. But once it's cleaned for the first time professionally and then sealed, this will last 5 to 7 years at that point then.
At a minimum. Yeah, at a minimum.
Do you also take care of mold removal in case somebody didn't seal it properly? Do you, like restore grout that's been damaged?
We do, and we see a lot of that in showers. So that's a great question as well. But yeah, so we'll, when we have a situation like that, especially in a shower, we'll grind out all of the caulking or the grout, and we'll regrout it.
Now, this obviously takes a lot of time. I mean, what's a typical time frame to do a house that has, you know, maybe a 1,500 square foot house, for instance, that may have a tile kitchen, bath, and stuff? You know, and I'm just using general numbers, but time frame for getting a job like that completed. How long would something like that take?
Generally, a job that size, we would probably have three people on the job because in a lot of cases, it requires moving furniture back and forth, that sort of thing. But generally, if we have three people on a job like that, if it's 18-inch tile, it would take roughly a day to get it finished. And generally, once we're finished, the people can walk on the floors within 15 or 20 minutes.
And do you move the furniture around for the homeowners, or are they expected to have the floors prepped and ready for y'all to come in? I always wonder about that with, like, the carpet cleaners and stuff. I feel bad for those guys. They got to move all kinds of stuff, or do they expect the homeowners to move that stuff around?
You know, we move all the large things. I try to ask them to move bar stools. Anything that they can move off the floors is helpful because I try to let them know, listen, we're here to do the floors. We don't mind doing light moving. But we ask them to move like plants and things and bar stools off of the table.
Now, what type of chemicals are involved in this process? Are there any risks to any of the pets or anything like that that may, you know, lick the floor or something after the fact, after a cleaning, for instance?
Not at all. Our cleaners are water-based and our sealants are water-based. So, no, we don't have any issues at all with pets or people that have allergies or things like that. There's very little smell.
And how big is your team now?
You know, I've got one lead guy that's been with me for 3 years, and I have two or three others that are usually helpers. I generally handle all the sales and marketing myself, and occasionally I will be on site for a bigger job to help out with the staff.
And this is just, I feel for people in doing what you're doing because, I mean, talking about getting down on your hands and knees.
Yeah, backbreaking.
Yeah, I mean, that's some difficult work. Now, initial treatments, though, you're using the steamers, and you can do that from a standing position. But the sealant, though, you said you got to get down on the hands and knees. And is there no trick to that, then, is there?
There's no trick to that. We're fortunate in the sense that our four-step process, the only time we have to get on our hands and knees is when we get on these padded knee caddies where we use a toothbrush and apply the sealant line by line. So we're fortunate in that regard. Some of the other tile companies do all the steps on their hands and knees, which I think over the course of time can lead to mistakes. So at least we do have the buffing machine and we have the machine to scrub it initially. But yes, the gentlemen are very happy to get off their hands and knees by the end of the day.
What do you suggest is used underneath toilets, that little grout line that goes around the base of a toilet? Every once in a while, if it comes loose, it'll crack and become damaged. Is there different strengths of grout that can kind of solve that problem?
You know, sometimes around toilets, it's either going to be caulking, and sometimes that needs to be cut out and then re-caulked, or in some cases, it's grout. By us putting our sealant around it, it's certainly going to strengthen it, but there's no guarantees in that area because, you know, you've got weight going on the toilet. Sometimes grout's going to crack. So when we do repair grout, we tell the people up front, listen, we're going to repair this, and we certainly hope it lasts a long time, but there's a reason why it cracked in the first place.
How difficult is it to make sales in this business? I mean, there's so many different things that a homeowner needs to do. Grout is probably down on the lower end of, you know, what they want to do to the home. How difficult is it for you to, you know, make sales in this business and at Sir Grout?
That's a great question. Obviously, homeowners are going to take care of their plumbing issues, roofing issues, electric issues before they're probably going to look at the tile and grout. What we try to do, especially for people that are trying to sell their homes, is like, let's give the potential buyer several less things that they're going to have to deal with. And oftentimes when people come in, you know, first impressions are really important. So when they come in, you know, through the front door or start walking through the kitchen, I try to make the homeowner aware, well, you know, we can make this look brand new. But you're right. Grouting is not the most important thing on their minds, but we try to do our best to do so. And as far as, you know, competitors go, I have a lot of competitors. There's times where there'll be as many as five or six that I compete with, and then there's times where people may meet with us and purchase right there and then. It just
and
varies.
You mentioned, though, oftentimes you may come in higher than competitors because you're dealing with the carpet people out there that are not really doing the same service that you're doing. So I want to make that clear. So for the people that are listening out there, make it clear, you know, how you differentiate yourself from the other people out there doing the service.
I feel like the overall value that we bring is really second to none in the sense that, you know, once we do our service, it's going to last for years. It really is, as long as people take care of it properly. You know, a carpet cleaning guy or woman, they're going to usually develop a relationship with a customer in the sense that they're there usually once or twice a year to do their carpets, whereas once I come and do their tile and grout, I really don't see them for 5 or 6 or 7 years unless they want us to come in and do a maintenance cleaning to maintain the cleanliness of the floor.
So that's a challenge in your business, too. You know, a lot of people rely on follow-up you know, with their customers, but you've got to wait 5 to 7 years for a follow-up. So hopefully you're getting the referrals at least out of the...
It is. It can be a challenge. I follow up with my customers constantly to see how things are going. Usually I give them a six-month check where I call, say, how's everything going? Mm-hmm. Do you need cleaner? Things like that.
Well, don't you take any part in new construction and maybe track homes? Does that help out?
We do, yeah. And actually, last year I probably did 15 brand new homes where oftentimes the builder won't necessarily recommend a grout cleaning company, but somehow they hear about us through online or some of my ads. And we do a lot more brand new homes where people want to get it professionally sealed before they move in. That's a great question.
Where is the biggest touch point for people with their homes? Is it when they first move into a home that they just want a complete cleaning? Or do people just do this sporadically just throughout their ownership?
Like remodels?
Yeah. I mean, oftentimes if they're going to do a remodel of a kitchen or something and they want to hire us, I generally say we want to go last because we don't want any of the vendors walking on the floors. But it's my job just to try to make it important for them to get the floors looking clean and sealed. And a lot of people don't realize that you can bring those floors back to where they do look brand new.
All right, currently talking to Greg Lynch. He is the owner of Sir Grout here in Tampa, and you can learn more about this at sirgrouttampa.com or give him a call at 813-948-2488. Again, 813-948-2488, and again, sirgrouttampa.com. You're listening to That Business Show, Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Tosseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at ricktosseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Tosseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project. In an age when the good and the better vie for attention, it is the best that stands out. The best of Tampa Bay from proudly Florida is the love story for the city of Tampa, celebrating success, sharing achievements, a tribute to enterprise and community spirit. Let proudly Florida showcase your business to your city, your nation, and the world. For more information, email info@proudlyflorida.com and be sure to visit proudlyflorida.com.
I knew Mom wanted to stay at home. It's the center of her family, her life. But helping Mom stay in her home while managing mine was just too much. Honestly, it wasn't just about me. Mom didn't want me to be her caretaker. She wanted me to be her daughter. I felt so alone until I found out about Home Instead Senior Care. When we met the people at Home Instead, we just knew they were different. The experience was personal. And most importantly, for Mom and me, I get to be her daughter again.
Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank. And that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
How many times have you said to yourself, I wish there was an app for that? Stop wishing and start making the world better. Turn your brilliant idea into a profitable business by using Popcorn Apps. Their affordable app design will help get your blue sky idea or proven business to the next level at a fraction of the cost of other developers. They will help you get through all the steps needed to make your thoughts become live. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn. or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a million-dollar business and a world changer starting today.
Teresa Turner is a certified public accountant and the founder of Tax Happens, a boutique-style CPA firm providing small businesses and individuals with hands-on, personalized tax and accounting services. Although we would love to tell you how happy their clients are, we would like you to see for yourself. Tax Happens has 21 Google reviews and a 4.8-star Google rating, 17 Yelp reviews and a 5-star Yelp rating, 38 Facebook reviews and a 4.9-star Facebook rating. What sets Tax Happens apart is, number one, upfront pricing, two, clear deadlines, three, personally available year-round, and number four, a willingness to empower clients to do as much or as little as they desire. Visit taxhappens.com for more information.
Savvy business owners utilize technology to connect with customers, communicate among teams, and collaborate with partners. Even with advances in technology, you all know it's not infallible. Where do you turn when your technology starts working against you? Who do you depend on to keep your team productive? Don't wait until your technology fails you. Get ahead of the crisis and contact the professionals at Alpha Computing Solutions so they can show you how to keep your technology running smoothly. Visit them online at www.alphacomputing.com. Computing.com.
From the RP Funding Traffic Network.
Crash in downtown Tampa on westbound Kennedy Boulevard near the exit lanes from the Summit Express lanes. Also, we've got slow traffic on the westbound side of the Summit Expressway between 301 and 50th Street. Eastbound State Road 52 still very slow between Bellamy Brothers Boulevard and Old Pasco Road due to construction. And the southbound side of the Veterans Expressway, it's slow from Hutchinson to Waters. See traffic problems. Call the injury firm of Abrahamson Udrich. Hillsborough Traffic Tip Line 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by SOS Children's Villages. War, poverty, and disaster have left millions of children around the world orphaned, abandoned, alone. When their parents can't be there, SOS Children's Villages is there in 134 countries, including the U.S. To make a difference in a child's life, go to sosusa.org.
Today, sunny, then a 40% chance of showers and thunderstorms, high 92. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 77. Tomorrow, a 40% rain chance with a high 91.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 WINS WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Currently talking to Greg Lynch, owner of Sir Grout here in Tampa. And learn more about him over at SirGroutTampa.com or give him a call at 813-948-2488. And we're talking during the break, and he's got like three celebrity lookalikes, but Josh has settled on one of them right now. So who's the winner?
Well,
here?
First, let's go over the ones that we decided against. I said Mark Cuban.
Yeah.
But he's way too thin to be Mark Cuban. Yeah, Mark Cuban has like a round head. Rick said Mitt Romney, and he strongly suggested we do not use Mitt Romney. And but I came up with, like, I'm a big horror movie fan, and I couldn't help noticing that the guy strongly resembled one of my favorite actors. I'm trying to mirror the image. Or unmirror their image. But so I decided on the actor from Army of Darkness and Burn Notice, Bruce Campbell.
Bruce Campbell.
Yeah.
I see a little bit there.
Oh, you got to just rain all over my parade, don't you?
Well, there was a better one out there that he said that he's been compared to a lot,
yeah,
too.
Harbaugh.
Jim Harbaugh. Jim Harbaugh. Yeah. He's a coach these days, yes. Right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. And
For the Bulls, right?
Which teams he coach?
No, actually, I think he's coaching in college at Michigan right now.
Is he? Okay. Yeah. But yeah, he does look like Jim Harbaugh.
Did I at least have the sport right?
No. So. He's football, right? He's football, right? He's football. Yeah, that's basketball.
What I get for reading too much comics, man.
Josh, not known for his knowledge of sports, but anything nerd related, though, he knows. That's
why
he's
MMA,
the host of Nerd
I know
Talk.
How to fight.
Yeah, that is true. He is the host of Nerd Talk, though, not Sports Talk. So, Greg, you have other services in addition to just grout cleaning and refinishing. Granite ceilings, another one. Tell us a little about this.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, when people go to clean their granite, no matter what they do, they put their hands across, and you can still feel these little particles. What we do is called a wet scrape with a neutral cleaner. And then we just polish it with a clear seal afterwards. And it kind of makes everything a lot easier as far as cleaning and things like that. With granite, you always have to be careful with citric products, you know, your orange juices, grape juices, mm-hmm. and things like that, because they can damage it.
Oh, really? I didn't think anything damaged granite other than a sledgehammer, maybe. But no. So you spill some orange juice on there, that can hurt the granites?
Yeah, okay. That's right. Yep.
I noticed that my granite, and I had to look at it with a glare, but I'll see like little water stains, water spots. Mm-hmm. You don't see it when you look at it in normal lighting, but from a glare, you can see it all across there.
Oh, you're homeowner, huh?
What is that? Is that just because the granite wasn't sealed? Or something?
That could be part of it.
And it never comes up. It won't come up.
Yeah. I mean, again, try a wet scrape with it and then seal it, or call me. We'll come out and take a look at it for you.
And you also do shower renewal, shower doors treatments. Tell us about this.
We do. A lot of times people have these patterns where their shower door gets foggy and they just can't seem to clean it. We do have a product for which we wipe it and make it look brand new. We finally found something that works really well for that.
That's those films that form on those shower doors are, I mean, it's incredible how difficult it is to get that stuff off there. I mean, none of the household cleaners tend to do much of a damage on it. So you can get those things looking crystal clear again, just like new glass?
We absolutely can. Another little tip on showers is, even though we all have, you know, the fans and the showers and the master bathrooms, oftentimes those fans really aren't good enough in order to keep the moisture out of the shower. So we usually suggest to people to keep the shower doors open for 2 hours after every shower so that it dries quicker in there. That way you're less apt to grow mold underneath the shower door or along the bottom of the shower.
Good tip. Yeah. We've got about a minute left. Greg, where do you see your business at in 5 years? What's your growth strategy? Are you trying to expand outside of the Tampa Bay region? Are you happy where you're at now? Just tell us about the future of
Grout. I'm pleased with the region here locally. I'm always looking to hire more folks. Had a difficult time in doing so. I've been through a lot of different workers over the years. And a lot of it's based on, you know, the number of hours. A lot of times people want to work 40 hours, and I don't always have 40 hours for them. But as far as the growth process goes, I would like to get another van and have somebody drive it, but I have to find someone that I can trust to do so. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I'm constantly looking to grow the business. I do a lot of home shows, I do a lot of print ads, and I do a lot of online advertising as well.
All right. Good information from another entrepreneur here in the Tampa Bay region, Greg Lynch, owner of Sir Grout. Thank you so much for being in the studio, Greg.
Thanks again for having me.
And again, you can learn more about him over at sirgrouttampa.com or pick up the phone and give him a call at 813-948-2488. Again, 813-948-2488. He does grout cleaning services, but he also does some granite ceiling, shower renewal, and also can get your shower doors looking like new again. So visit sirgrouttampa.com. Also, thank you to Avavit Ben-Aaron. She was on in the 7 o'clock spot. She is a speech therapist and uses an online portal there to communicate with her clients. So a neat little technique to where you don't have to go in the office, and she gets some great results from that. And you can learn more about that over at greatspeech.com. That's greatspeech.com. Please learn more about this program over at tampabayradio.com. Connect with me on all social media sites, facebook.com/thatbusinessshow. And you'll find me on Twitter under Jamie_Maloney. You've been listening to That Business Show, Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.